Christof Loy, welcome back to Stockholm. This is your fifth production at the Royal Swedish Opera. I imagine that you have an attraction to this house. Am I right?
Obviously. I think from the first time on, I felt that he is a wonderful work ethics that I was, when I did La Fanciulla del West here, that it was a great teamwork together with the solists, chorus, and this carried me through, you know, this period there, and since then I always like to come back, and for very different pieces actually.
And what about your interest in Franz Schreker? Is it a new interest, or has it been growing, or?
Yeah, I think it, for me, it came naturally after I have worked a lot on the works by Richard Strauss, and to get, you know, a little bit more familiar with the style around, you know, the long time that Richard Strauss wrote, but especially, you know, the beginning of 20th century, I wanted to explore more, and actually it started as last year that I rediscovered together with the conductor Mark Albrecht a piece by Korngold, Das Wunder der Heliane. And in the whole preparation time of this production, I wanted to find out more about the composers of the so-called entartete Musik. So because Korngold, like Franz Schreker, was, you know, on the blacklist of the Nazi regime, and I felt when I worked on Korngold, I really want to do justice, you know, to this composer, and it is the same feeling now for Franz Schreker.
Yes, at the center of the FERNE KLANG is an artist, the composer Fritz, and a woman for sure, both making their life choices. Fritz makes a journey out of inner compulsion. Is it an early 20th century opera that breaks up with the then perhaps and still prevailing artist myth?
Let's say like that, it is the male main character is a composer, an artist who is on the, you know, the journey trying to find his own language as a composer, and so in a certain way you can say it is about a struggling artist and an artist's life. I think the choices that an artist has to make, it is always similar to all of us. We have to make choices in life. So choosing in art is, you know, very much the same as choosing in life for every human being. The female main character, Grete, is, I think it is a very typical profile in the way of the beginning of the 20th century, this kind of femme fatale, the way this woman is portrayed as a kind of prostitute of luxury, so it goes back, if you like, you know, to La Traviata. But often, you know, when people today see La Traviata, they don't even realize that it's about a prostitute. But here it is quite clear, about, because the whole second act is built around that. That it is that, like Fritz, when he sees her again after many years, that it's just like the audience. I think I play a little bit with the fact that I like that the audience discovers more and more during the act, you know, that it's not only a lady who is flattered by many men, but it's very clear that she gets a fee.
Yeah. So on the surface, she is kind of femme fatale.
Yeah.
But she also has the complexity. In a way, we can say it is a happy end with the Greta and Fritz reunion. But on the other hand, it's a total disaster.
Yeah. It's an interesting question. Some people say, oh, it's not a happy end, of course, because Fritz is dying at the end. But I feel this is actually that they find each other after all these years and that they finally notice that they loved each other during all these years, even if they were not united in lifetime. I think this is such a fantastic experience that I think this is more than happiness, because some people don't ever experience this. And it is, of course, not lucky, that they couldn't, live with each other. But I think it is, they both had, until then, a very intense life, I would say. And I think maybe they can only experience this moment of finding out what happiness really is because of that.
Thank you so much, Christof Loy, and toi 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 for the premiere on October 5th.
Thank you, it was a pleasure.